Sam and Avery live 330 miles apart. Sam will drive toward Avery at a rate of 50 miles per hour. Avery will drive toward Sam at a rate of 60 miles per hour. After how long will they meet, and how far from Sam's house will they be? So this is a two-part question. We'll answer the first one. After how long will they meet? Let's do that first. Okay, this is a classic distance equals rate times time problem. So distance equals rate times time. The distance that is traveled here, let's look at this. Let's look at Sam in the red car. And he's going in this direction. This is Sam. And Avery, let's put Avery in the blue car. Okay, Avery is driving in this direction. And at some point in the middle, they'll meet. I shouldn't say in the middle because it's going to be offset from the middle just a little bit. They're going in these opposite directions. Sam's distance is his rate multiplied by his time. So his rate is 50 miles per hour. So his distance is 50 times t. And Avery's distance is going to be her rate of 60 miles per hour times time, because distance equals rate times time. So Avery's distance is 60 t. Okay, let's do that. We've got our distances there. And the total distance, we know that the total distance is 330 miles. So if we add this 50t, that is Sam's distance, plus Avery's distance, we should get a total of 330 miles. So let's do that. We'll say 50t plus 60t equals 330. That's 330. Now let's solve this equation, and you get 110t equals 330. Divide each side by 110 to solve this equation, and you get an answer of t equals 3 hours. So they will meet after driving 3 hours. Okay, let's take a look at the second question. The second question is, how far from Sam's house will they be? Well, the distance that Sam is traveling again is 50t. So this distance equals 50 times our t, and that is 3 hours. So they will be 150 miles from Sam's house. So it looks like Avery is driving just a little bit farther than Sam. Well, that makes sense because she is driving faster.